बाद में बता दीजिएगा, अंग्रेजी बाद में पूछ लीजिएगा।
ऑनरेबल चेयरपर्सन प्लीज स्टार्ट इट फ्रेश बिकॉज 16 सेकंड्स आर लॉस्ट। सी प्रेसिडेंट्स एड्रेस समराइज़ द अचीवमेंट्स मेड बाय द गवर्नमेंट, इट ऑल्सो मैप्स आउट द फ्यूचर कोर्स ऑफ एक्शन एंड इन द प्रेजेंट केस प्रेसिडेंट्स एड्रेस काउंट्स abrogation of special status of Jammu and Kashmir as one of the achievements. Sir, I maintain that abrogation of special status, abrogation of 370, Article 370 and division of Jammu and Kashmir has been a historical blunder. And it is not anything less than a misadventure. The address does not mention that the abrogation of special status and revocation of 370 in the first place goes against fundamental values of Indian polity, the values that have been cherished by this country for thousands of years. Every day you begin this, I mean every sitting is, we begin it with the slogan Jai Shri Ram. And everybody knows that Jai Shri was, we know Maryada Parshottam. He embodiment of morality and truth, the basic value of truthfulness. That was murdered in case of abrogation of Article 370 and abrogation of special status of Jammu and Kashmir. The decision of 5th August does not only make an assault on the fundamental values, but amounts to unilateral breach of commitments made to the people of Jammu and Kashmir. In the first place, it was 1947, the commitments made. That were upgraded, given the status of constitutional guarantees. What is Article 370 except the constitutional guarantees that were agreed upon by the government of India and Constituent Assembly? And commitment was unilaterally, its breach was committed. Second was of 1952, again approved by the Indian Parliament on 5th August 1952. And third was 1975 Kashmir Accord. Most of the members who are right now senior members part of this parliament must have been in this parliament when Kashmir Accord was entered into between late Sheikh Mohammed Abdullah and Madam Indira Gandhi. That Kashmir Accord gave a guarantee that relations between Jammu and Kashmir and the country will be governed by Article 370. Now please tell me, you have unilaterally committed breach of all these commitments made, and does not that offend the basic principles of federalism that amount to, that are in the nature of basic structure as laid down by the Supreme Court, basic structure of the Constitution. So by unilateral breach of these commitments, how can you give any kind of confidence to Bodo people with whom you are entering into an agreement? Are the negotiations you have hold with Nagas that we will go for an agreement? What guarantee they have that agreement will be respected when you unilaterally committed breach of all these three commitments made in the Constituent Assembly in 1952 Parliament and thereafter? Sir, the narrative build-up to market these decision of 5th was, the narrative was, it was a fake narrative. Just 2 months back, you would tell entire world that Jammu Kashmir is the best state in the country, and after two months, you say that we lag behind in development. All the human development indices are in favor of Jammu and Kashmir. We are ahead of 15 states in the country. No starvation deaths, no farmer suicides, no one without a roof over his head, no starvation deaths as we saw in case of Muzaffarpur, no raw lychee deaths, nothing like that. We were far ahead of the rest of the 15 states. Still, that false narrative that 370 stands between development and the Jammu and Kashmir. Now, please tell me, the 10 states that are much below Jammu and Kashmir, there was no 370. Why did not they assure an era of development in those states? Now, this false narrative is belied by the day in and day out assurance they made to Northeast. All that was given to the Kashmir or was present in case of Kashmir is now being promised to the Northeast. Even inner line permit system, domicile rights, land rights, employment rights are guaranteed. Does not that belie the narrative that the false narrative that you build up to market 5th August decisions? Sir, it is not only we were, the Jammu and Kashmir was denuded of its identity, denuded of its autonomy, stripped of its territorial integrity, and that too in gross violation of the Constitution. It was expected that once the Supreme Court admitted the petitions, least that was expected was that the state, the government will put its decisions on hold. Sir, our finance minister, quoted a couplet of Dinanath Nadim. She picked up the couplet. She did not know that he was one who loved Kashmir and whose every song was for Kashmir. He was the greatest patriot, and I think he had been alive, he would have felt so discomforted pain that his couplet was used to legitimize something that was an assault on his motherland. His first book was Moj Kashmir, the Mother Kashmir. And what did he write? And it appears that as if he envisioned, as he visualized that what will be plight of his Kashmir in 2019. What did he say? Who told you, my mother Kashmir, that you are supportless, you are without any support, and you are helpless? I am with you. Who told you that your nightingale does not sing, and or he has just stopped singing for you? And his again, Mother Kashmir, she does not know the finance minister. Burbadiyev, as if he knew it, what is happening to Kashmir, going to happen to Kashmir. Burbadiyev, vatan ka kisna main kya sunaun, iflas ki kahani kis kis ko ja sunaun, rahe ke mere dil par churiyan si chal rahi hai. It is his book, Mother Kashmir, Moj Kashmir, Madre Kashmir. रह रह के मेरे दिल पर छुरियां सी चढ़ रही हैं, आंखों से मेरे आंसू की नदियां बह रही हैं. And what have we achieved, honorable chairperson? What did we, let us see in a dispassionate manner, I request, on the other side, what did we achieve? Does Kashmir dispute cease to be there? What prompted you to take on a guided tour, European parliamentarians and the ambassadors to Kashmir?
Please.
Second, justice. And second is, has it ceased to exist? It is there.
Please.
It is
this. Not fair.
See, it is, the Kashmir dispute continues to be there to stare you on in face and whatever militancy. It has now reached new levels. Now inroads, see what kind of inroads the militancy has made. You have a senior most police officer apprehended and alleged to be hand and glove with militants. And this is the senior officer to whom you had entrusted security of Ambassador of the United States. And yesterday, a few days back, you arrested a police officer from Kupwara, again on the same allegation. And a day before, you raided a leader of the party in power in Shupaya. See, is there any kind of relief from militancy? Every day, the incidents of militancy go. With every passing day, we have encounters. Every passing day, we have on border, we have situation on border. And why did we? My appeal would be, please acknowledge that it has been unconstitutional, it is unilateral, breach of commitments. Please undo whatever you have done on 5th, because you have not achieved anything. Rather, it has widened the gulf between people of Jammu and Kashmir and people of Kashmir.
Thank you.
And then, The president status does not make mention of the blockade, longest blockade in history as was mentioned.
Sunil Kumar Singh Pinto.
Arrest and detention of Dr. Farooq Abdullah and Umar Abdullah and Mahbub Mufti and other senior leaders.
Thank you.
So my appeal would be, please give it a second look. You have not achieved anything yet. You are not going to achieve anything. The matter is there. The problem is there. It's better to...
Pinto ji.